First of all, I'd like to get your perspective on how you look at food and what is in your mind, why do we eat? I know that most of us eat because we're hungry, but how do we, what do you, what from your perspective, what is food and why do we eat?
Thank you, Ramesh. Happy to be here. And there are two simple questions, but there are many layers there. And maybe we can look at it, you know, from two different perspectives or three different perspectives. First, let's take up what's food. And so the question of what is food, right, is so important before we answer why we eat it. Because it turns out that not all of us eat for the same reason. We eat food for different reasons. And even the same person eats food for multiple different reasons, right? So let's look at a basic perspective of what is food. Right? Food is anything that nourishes us, right? Anything that keeps me alive, anything that keeps Nisha walking and talking, anything that builds myself, right, and also repairs myself and also manages to clone myself, right, either as an offspring or for my own growth. So that's like a basic definition of food, as anything that nourishes me and as a building block of my body, right? It is the building block of all my cells and my very existence in that sense. Now, if you want to like ask what is good food, then the question is slightly different, right? Good food does all of the above, and it leaves least residue in our body, right? So then our body doesn't have to do so much hard work and huff and puff to eliminate all these non-digestibles that are all part of our processed and packeted foods these days, right? So that would be good food, the food that builds our body and does not leave residue in our body. Now, then another perspective is like, what is ideal food, right? I would say that ideal food is food that is taken in consciously. It is eaten from a perspective of hunger, and it is eaten not just to keep ourselves alive, but also with the consciousness of not harming other living beings, not harming our own emotions, and not harming our environment, right? And so that for me would be like ideal food or conscious food. So there are these different perspectives of food, and the nature care framework that I subscribe to experientially live into, it looks at ideal food, right? And says it's made up of five elements, or panchabhuta, as our traditional wisdom would call it. So for us, food in Nature Cure is never just about what's on the plate. It's about the five elements of space, air, light, water, and whatever grows from the earth or under the earth. So this conscious food is eaten from the perspective of maintaining my internal and external balance and harmony. So within these five-fold food of space, air, light, water, and earth-based food, the space, air, and light are classified into subtle foods, subtle elements, because they are harder to perceive with our senses. And water and earth-based foods are easier to perceive with our senses, right? I can touch it, I can hear it, and so on. So water and earth-based foods, which are the plants and other things that we eat, are gross elements. And space, air, and light are subtle elements. And together, all five of them constitute fivefold food. And if somebody asks me to name one thing I have experientially learned from Nature Cure, I would experientially, empirically, and exponentially learn from Nature Cure, then I would say this without hesitation. The subtle foods of space, air, and light nourishes much more than gross food. And it's not intuitive to understand, but experientially it can be felt. And to that extent, these subtle elements are higher quality food than gross elements. So if I take in optimal amount of, you know, space through fasting, air through pranayama and light through sun basking. So if fasting, pranayama and taking in sunlight become as much a part of my daily routine as breakfast, lunch and dinner, right, this planet would just be filled with healthy, healthy people. So does it answer what is food?
No, absolutely. I think it's a very interesting, unique perspective I've not heard before. Because whenever we talk about food, we talk about what's on our plate, right? So, or what's in our glass. And we don't look at, the subtle elements in the way you've described it. So it's very beautiful. I strongly, personally, experientially also, I believe that the sun, and I didn't think so much about the air, but I do believe the sun and the fasting part of it are absolutely essential. Because you need to actually give the body some amount of rest, some amount of space for it to digest whatever you put in and not just keep feeding it again and again. So I think that is absolutely essential.